Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the topic transducers. It is your syllabus topic present in the 5th unit of basic electrical and electronics measurement engineering, that is electrical measurement. The contents of this presentation includes transducers, its block diagram, classification, and in detail we are going to discuss about 5 main types of transducers. They are strain gauge, resistance thermometer, linear variable differential transformer, light dependent resistor, and finally piezoelectric transducer. Come on, let's move on to the topic. Transducer is nothing but it is used in measurement applications in various fields. It is nothing but a device that helps in converting non-electrical quantity into electrical quantity. So the basic thing a transducer will do is it simply helps in converting non-electrical quantities like force, displacement, stress, temperature, etc. into electrical quantity, mainly current, voltage, resistance, inductance, etc. If we see the block diagram of transducers, it mainly comprises of 2 main blocks. The first block is the sensing element and the second block is the transduction element. The input, it may be pressure or temperature or force, is applied to the sensing element, and the function of the sensing element is to produce measurable response to the change in physical quantity applied to it. And when it gives output to the transduction element, this element or this device converts the non-electrical sensor output from the sensing element block into suitable electrical signal. We have many classification of transducers, and some important types are active and passive transducers, analog and digital transducers, and there are many types of transducers on the basis of transduction principle used, primary and secondary transducers, and finally transducers and inverse transducers. Active transducer is one that will not require any external source of power for their operation. That is, when operating, it will not require any external power supply. They are broadly classified into photovoltaic, thermoelectric, electromagnetic, piezoelectric, chemical, and others. Whereas a passive transducer needs external source of power for their operation. The external power may be a DC power supply or an audio frequency generator. There are many classifications of passive transducer that you can see from the figure that I have shown here. But in the syllabus, we are going to discuss only 5 main types of transducers. So the first one is strain gauge. Second one is linear variable differential transformer. And third one is light dependent resistor, fourth one is resistance thermometer, and finally piezoelectric transducers. So before going in to explain in detail about the different types, let us see what is the primary and secondary transducer mean. That is, if in a circuit we are having 2 transducers, the transducer that help in converting a physical quantity into mechanical signal is called as a primary transducer, and the transducer that helps in converting the mechanical signal into electrical signal is called as a secondary transducer. So according to the transduction principle, transducers are classified into capacitive, electromagnetic, inductive, piezoelectric, photovoltaic, and photoconductive. And like voice, where transducers or the devices help in converting non-electrical quantity to electrical quantity, there are also inverse transducers which help in converting electrical quantity to non-electrical quantity. So this is going to be our first main type of transducer, that is strain gauge. So from the name you can identify that you are going to apply some stress or strain or force which is going to be converted into electrical signal by the transducers. That's why they are called as strain gauge. So in the gauge wire, we are going to apply an external force, and due to the applied force there will be variation in change and cross-sectional area of the gauge wire, by which this transducer is converting this mechanical elongation and compression into change in resistance. So by measuring the change in resistance, we are going to measure the amount of external force, that is strain, applied to the gauge wire. So this is the basic principle behind a strain gauge. The next type of transducer is resistance thermometer. So thermometer is, we all know that it is a device used to measure the temperature. So here resistance thermometer is going to measure the temperature in terms of resistance. For example, if you take a metal, the resistance of the metal increases when there is increase in the temperature. So with the help of this principle, we are going to measure the amount of temperature applied to the metal by measuring the change in resistance. This is the principle involved in a resistance thermometer. The third very, very important type of transducer is linear variable differential transformer. This type of transducer is very important, so please be cautious in studying this question, because it is very important and it will be coming for your university exams also. So it is very simple to learn and also very simple to write and score marks. So please students, take a note of this and you concentrate and study well this question before going to the university exams. An LVDT is nothing but linear variable differential transformer. Like a transformer, it is also going to have two coils, one is primary, another one is secondary, but the difference is that we are going to use two secondary coils and one primary coil. The input is going to be given to the primary coil, and like a transformer there will be electromagnetic induction in the secondary coils. The fact is that when the core is in the center position, then when supply is given to the primary, the amount of voltage induced in the secondary coil 1 and secondary coil 2 will be same. It will be designed like that. But when the core is very near to secondary coil 1, there will be more induction in secondary coil 1 than 2. And when the core is very nearer to the secondary coil 2, more induction will be in the secondary coil 2 rather than secondary coil.
This produced in both coils will be opposite, they cancel each other. But when the core is very near to the secondary coil 1, there will be in the secondary coil 1. And when the core is very near to the secondary coil 2, there will be more induction in the secondary coil 2. So with the help of this principle, this LVDT, this linear variable differential transformer, can be used for measuring the displacements. The next one is the LDR, that is light dependent resistor. It is nothing but it is a variable resistor, that is it is going to have change in the value of resistance corresponding to the variation in the intensity of light. That is when light intensity is made to fall on this LDR, there will be change in resistance, because the resistance of a phototransistor decreases with increasing intensity of the incident light. So correspondingly, the incident light, when it gets increased, there will be decrease in the resistance, and with the help of this principle, this LDR can be used to measure the amount of light that is made to incident on this device. Finally, piezoelectric transducer. This is one of the most interesting transducer present here. It is a type of electrical transducer. It uses the properties of piezoelectric materials. Piezoelectric materials generally have a property for helping the conversion of physical quantities into electrical signals. For example, piezoelectric material, if we apply some mechanical stress or strain, due to the movement of ions, there will be generation of electrical voltage, and the amount of electrical voltage generated within the piezoelectric material will be proportional to the applied stress. So, with the help of this principle, we can easily measure any physical quantity like a strain or stress, since it is getting converted into electrical signal like electrical voltage. So this is all about the topic transducers. So I hope you students have well understood about the transducers, its block diagrams, classifications, and the five main types of transducers. If you are having any queries, means feel free to ask me. Thank you.